Okay, I admit, the talk and posture too much is not exactly a fresh hot take, and people have poked fun of that before, but it's not always about originality. Sometimes you just feel like making something and then you just gotta do it, you know? This has been sitting around for a while. I recorded this well over a year ago and meant to actually find an editor to do the visual effects and, you know, ended up asking a few people, but then I always end up doing things myself because juggling stuff back and forth and coordinating with others is just seems tedious, even though it's kind of dumb because ending up spending so much time on it is tedious, but hey, at least then I've got the satisfaction of I made it all by myself. Even though it could have looked a lot better if somebody more professional had done it. I guess a quick warning is in order. This is going to be very rambly. It's not going to be educational. I'm just basically going to be babbling about something that I feel like babbling about. So if you're not up for that, there's plenty else to watch, both on my channel and others, preferably on my channel, of course. As far as Dragon Ball is concerned, both Z and Super, I have a bit of a complicated relationship with it, so to speak. I used to watch it quite a bit, Z, and then more recently I tried to get into Super and kind of couldn't. My main problem with it is the contrast between the serious, epic, awesome stuff and this really obnoxiously silly slapstick garbage that's tagged on. This is an anime trope. That's one of the reasons why I'm not that fond of anime in general. I understand there are different types of it. Shonen, I think, is the type that's directed at a younger audience that has all the silly nonsense with somebody's head suddenly becoming huge and like overly excessive expressions of emotions and blah, whatever. This kind of stuff I always find really, really annoying that takes you out of it, or me at least. Anyway. The whole thing about they talk too much and let the other power up for several episodes and all of that. There's definitely a lot of dragging things out way more than it needs to be. But at the same time, they do also acknowledge it at least some of the time. You know, like for example, when Goku had to restrain Raditz to allow Piccolo to charge his special beam cannon and then blast through both of them. That's a way to do it properly. You know, if you have an attack that takes a lot of charging time, the enemy's not just gonna stand there and wait for you to finish unless, you know, they're being distracted. Also the same way when Goku first prepared the spirit bomb against Frieza, he didn't let him just do the thing. He did attack him and interrupt him, and Piccolo tried to distract him long enough, etc. And when Vegeta took 5 minutes to charge his final flash against Cell, at least it also made sense because he deliberately challenged Cell to take it. It was, you know, it's an ego thing. You know, Cell in particular is way up his own ass. So that makes perfect sense to just kind of goad someone into, I bet you're too much of a pussy to take my full powered attack, and then they're like, okay, I'll bring it. And then it's more powerful than expected. But there's definitely a lot of stuff that could have been cut out quite easily, where things just keep going on and on and on, and oh, yet another new form? Oh, what a big surprise. That's actually my main problem with it. It's just, it tries so hard to up the ante all the time and raise the stakes and build tension that it goes overboard, and it's just the same old, same old. As far as predictability is concerned, I guess you can argue either way. On the one hand, you can say that if you have a certain theme and a fixed build-up, then it's consistent. You know, people who like a show for what it does can come back to it over and over again and expect the same thing, which is good. But on the other hand, the problem with always having the exact same arc, meaning super powerful enemy comes along, nobody has any chance to beat them. They need to go through a lot of stress or maybe lose something or someone, and the stakes need to get higher and higher to the point where they can break past the barrier and power up some more, and now they're super powerful and kick the enemy's ass, and then the enemy reveals that, oh, they haven't been fighting at 100%, and now they power up, and now it's completely uneven again, or transformation, or whatever, and then it just, you know, keeps going like that. Is, yeah, I mean, if you want to increase tension and raise the stakes, are you really doing that if it's that predictable? Another tangent. My main problem with Dragon Ball Z and Super is that they just, at some point, they just canceled a bunch of characters. They just left them behind in the dust. You know, I remember back when Piccolo fused with Kami, it was a big deal. Like, oh my goodness, now he's a god. And he should have been, you know, crazy powerful. Yeah, it lasted for what? An episode or two? You know, like, he had his brief moment in the sun, and then he was immediately outclassed, and now it goes back to Goku. It should just be called The Goku Show, because every time somebody else has a chance to shine for a brief moment, you know, like Trunks, immediately outclassed. You know, when Trunks shows up and cuts Frieza straight in half, after all this huge, long drama trying to fight Frieza, he comes along, cuts him in half, and then Goku shows up and just blocks his sword with his fingers. It's just, I mean, come on. You gotta give someone else a bit of room to breathe. Vegeta's gotten his chances here and there, but he's always outclassed. Of course, that's part of the point of it, because he's the more ego-driven one. We just need more relevant characters. They did apparently some more in Super when some of the other characters have a chance to fight weaker opponents, but my problem with this whole power level thing is they kept raising the ceiling and raising it to the point where it gets absolutely ridiculous. I mean, Frieza was already at planet destroying level, and he's a joke compared to Cell. Golden Frieza, yeah, is a lot more powerful, but then you in Super, you get into, you know, Beerus and everything, and it becomes ludicrous. So of course nobody can hang with that. So it's just Goku and Vegeta, yay! Why would you discard all the other characters? They used to have a kind of interesting role to play in their own, you know, backstory and their own techniques and skills, and now it's all whatever. No chance at all. So yeah, that bothers me a little bit. This is all over the place, but sometimes I just gotta do that. I can't always restrain my scatterbrained ramblings and just try to be on point. Sometimes I just gotta unleash and just blah, 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 blah. Hopefully at least some of you find it tolerable. Thanks for watching. Have a good one. People have pointed. Pointed? Point? Can you point fun at something? Kind of, right? You point and laugh. So you kind of, but you poke. Don't mind me. Just overthinking everything.